Discover Jazz on Vermont PBS is proudly presented by Northfield Savings Bank, serving Vermont communities with a tradition of donating 10% of its annual profits. We are a local bank striving to make Vermont a better place to live and work. Additional funding has been provided by the following contributors.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, each of us on our own, just the fundamental physical relationship with our instrument is the foundation for the improvisations that then form the basis of the songs that we write on our own. And so as this was, this project was just, we wanted to kind of marry the two solo concepts and unadulterated, so that they were really just as they are when we are alone. They would be that way together, and so it became something that where one would normally do the improvisation and it all would be solitary. It was communal, and there was a conversation now, but it was still based. Things were still based in improvisation as a starting point.
Thank you. so much. Thank you. Most people hear us play and they think that there's other sounds going on, so we're looping, and or there's some pre-recorded thing. So that's not an effect of using a reverb. Like, I use a short delay and a reverb that I change, which is simply a spatial effect thing. It's like allowing the listener and the music to move from small spaces to big spaces. So it's as if you were, oh, I'm now in a hallway. You know how like beautiful a bathroom sounds when you're singing and it's like a small, tight reverb. It's trickier on a fretless, tiny, wooden, awkward instrument, but it's pretty cool. And the sounds you can get in between all the sounds, that's where those different frequencies are happening.
Thank you.
we got to write some stuff that I feel like I've had, we've probably both had in our minds. And so it made that other side of it possible. Like, you know, I think like something like The Rest of Us was, you know, came out really naturally. It was just this like super, super heavy groove piece that was just so cathartic to play and to write. And it's like, that's kind of, I'd had that sort of thing in my, like, it just kind of is in there all the time. And it, he just, oh, look, he's playing it. Like, and so he does a lot of that where, you know, it's surprising, but it's not surprising. It's like, I feel like I've imagined this thing and all of a sudden he's doing it and it's bigger and darker and crazier and more beautiful than I could have actually imagined it. But he's making it. And so he's like really, it enables like this whole other world of possibility.
That was beautiful.
I would just add that that there's, and this it's almost like a generic of two people working together. Everyone is has a tendency to flip back into autopilot, but you don't necessarily know it when you're doing it. And so having the other there to really check that, and because it's having someone that knows every move that you make and can see like all aspects of your, you know, your musical personality, is very, very helpful, because they know when you slipped into autopilot and can check that, and then the music can, I don't know, can become more vibrant, more like more and more real and more relevant when the two of us kind of hear what one another is doing and are able to like weed out the auto.
Discover Jazz on Vermont PBS is proudly presented by Northfield Savings Bank, serving Vermont communities with a tradition of donating 10% of its annual profits. We are a local bank striving to make Vermont a better place to live and work. Additional funding has been provided by the following contributors.